explanation of transient phenomena such as gamma ray bursts, X-ray transient supernovas, soft gamma ray repeaters, and so on. Also, it should provide the sky mapping in the range from about dozens keV up to about 1 MeV, with the goal of search of new sources, first of all, like of active galactic nuclei, and also timing of well-known X-ray and gamma ray sources, like as well active galactic nuclei, X-ray and gamma ray pulsars, and neutron star and black hole binaries. And even if this instrument will be added by optical wide field cameras, also a specific task could be solved in such observations, and among them the observations of different optical transients caused by supernovas, as well as GRB prompt emission and afterglow, and also such event like small natural and artificial bodies, observation of such bodies in the near Earth space, including observations of dangerous meteors on the near Earth orbits. The main principle of this instrument is the combination of coding mask and position-sensitive detector and so-called quasispherical configuration. Really, it will be like a dodecahedron configuration, and such configuration should provide the wide field about 2 pst radian. It will have so-called model construction. It should consist from 6 identical pentagonal mask elements and corresponding 6 position-sensitive detectors. And propose several types of position-sensitive detector. The most well-studied, as I can say, is the combination of sodium and cesium iodide active shield position-sensitive detector, such as Foswich detector, and also the coding mask from tungsten or maybe tantalum. And also we have an intention to use the optical wide field cameras those three types which successfully use on-ground observations led by Professor Lipunov in master system. And as about GRB study, of course, the main ideas already were here today. It is the study of GRBs at most low sensitive level with lowest intensity and with low typical energy, because if we want to search sources at high redshifts due to cosmological redshift, the spectrum of such events should be softer, and thus we should try to detect the events more soft as possible. And of course, with low peak intensity. And thus, the instrument should provide the very low threshold of detecting quanta in X-ray as well, and also should provide a high sensitivity. And as we hope, the ability to GRB detection with this instrument will be such as listed here. It should provide sensitivity at about 10 in minus 8 erg per square centimeter level, and localization in gamma rays with error box about a half of degree, with temporal resolution for gamma ray about 10 microseconds, and in optics about 100 milliseconds. Expected number of GRBs with visible optical brightness less than 9 stellar magnitude, we expect about 20 events per year. But maybe it is an optimistic estimation. I should mention that now we prepare the other experiment. Maybe we will discuss it. It's so-called Lomonosov experiment, in which we also will use the combination of gamma ray detector and wide field cameras. And if this experiment will be realized, we will see how much events simultaneously in optics and in gamma rays we will detect. We expect that in Lomonosov we should detect about several such events each year. And due to higher sensitivity and larger field of view, we expect that in gamma scope experiment the such number will be greater. It is the general view of the instrument. As you could see here, it is really the combination of six position sensitive detector units and corresponding pentagonal plates, coding mask, which all of them form the construction such as a dodecahedron. And due to such quasi-spherical configuration, it is possible to observe really the half of the sky. And this provides the simultaneous observation of each source just about the time of observation. And in the case of also the use of optical camera, this is the general view of such camera in the protection cover. The idea is to add each gamma detector corresponding wide field optical camera. And this is the sketch of such construction. And in this case, there is not any necessity to redirect the optical instrument, as it is usually used in different space experiments. And due to such redirection, we lower the time. Maybe it is, could be very fast redirection, but nevertheless, about a few seconds we will lose. But in this case, we have no any delay in time between the gamma ray event and optical event. And also we could store the information in optics just before the gamma ray event. And thus we could detect not only the prompt emission without any losses in optics, but also the progenitors in the optic. And thus we will have an optic-like curve for the all event from progenitor to prompt emission and then to afterglow without any gaps and delays. And such instrument in the case of the so-called all sky survey mode, due to very large field of view, provides the very high sensitivity. It could be seen on this figure where we plot the sensitivity levels of different space instruments. And of course, all these sensitivities are in the survey mode. That means that we have a total time of the experiment, for example, 1 year. And then we recalculate the effective exposure time for each source, which is needed to realize all sky survey. And due to very large field of view, we see that such wide field gamma ray telescope provides the sensitivity at an order higher than, for example, integral IBIS instrument. And also we could estimate the number of extragalactic, first of all, active galactic nuclei like blazars, sources. On this figure we could see the plot of expected number of such sources, and parameter, which is multiplication of effective field of view of the instrument, exposure time, and effective area. And such parameters could be seen as the effective sensitivity parameter, because all these values define the sensitivity of the experiment. And in the assumption of 1.5 Lagrange-Laguerre distribution of the sources, which are expected for uniform space, we have such estimation for Blaser-like sources in different kinds of instrument realization and for different exposure, different time of experiment. Thus, for the time of about 3 years, we expect to detect about several dozens of such sources. And technical parameters of gamma scope instruments are listed here. We could see that it is not very heavy instrument. Its mass should be about, in different realizations, about 1.5 hundred kilograms, with power no more than 100 watts. The J informativity is only for gamma rays in so-called monitor mode. In the case of detection of GRB, of course, the data volume will be greater. And of course, for gamma, for optical cameras, the volume of data is much more higher. It is about several hundreds megabytes, or maybe several gigabytes. And now in Lomonosov, we will have an experience to transfer such data volumes, and it's onboard procession. The geometry factor, which is multiplication of effective area and field of view, is about 0.3 square meter on steradian. The angular resolution depends on the distance between the position-sensitive detector and coding mask, and of course it depends on the instrument size. But in a very compact configuration, it will be about 2, maybe 3 degrees. The typical energy range is from 50 keV up to 1 MeV, but I already said that now our goal is to make the low level as low as possible, with the goal to detect the most soft events. And now we could say that we could realize the low threshold about 10 keV, but maybe even we think some more, maybe it will be some lower, about maybe several keV. It will be good, as I think. And also, in the most compact configuration, the total effective area is about 500 square centimeter, but in optimal case, which could provide the appropriate sensitivity, we think that effective area should be several times higher, just about 2,000 square centimeter. And for such compact configuration, the typical sensitivity for about 10 kilosecond observation time is about 30 millicraps. And also here we could see the technical parameters of gamma detectors and wide field camera. As I already said, the camera of same type will be used in Lomonosov experiment, and we hope that it give us a good experience in the use of optical camera and space experiment. It is a rather compact instrument with mass no more than about several kilograms, with power about 10 watts, informativity per day about several gigabytes, and this camera, what is the principle, have a rather large field of view, about 20 on 40 degrees, with sensitivity level for about 200, 300 millisecond exposition, about 13, 14 stellar magnitude. And this curve characterizes the field of view of this wide field gamma ray instrument. And really, it is shows that its field of view is about 2 π steradian. Now we have a laboratory model of one position sensitive detector unit, and in the case of very low budget variant, which we now have already realized as a laboratory model, such position sensitive detector, it is a simple gamma camera based on the combination of two types of scintillators. One, it is the pixelized position-sensitive scintillator. In our case, it is sodium iodide scintillators. Consists from about 100 numbers of pixels of about 1 centimeter in diameter and 3 centimeter in length. And also the one crystal of cesium iodide scintillator on which pixels are mounted in such a way. And all and both scintillators are viewed by a few number of photomultiplier tubes. In this configuration, we use a small number of photo detectors, photo multipliers, and it make the cost of the instrument much lower, not so high, if we will use the PMT for each pixel. This is the general view of this laboratory model. And the principle of such a gamma camera is could be seen on this picture. The light from each pixel is passed through the cesium iodide scintillator crystal in a light cone. And in this way, the signal amplitude from each photomultiplier tube will be depend on the crystal position relative to the center of photomultiplier. And this dependence is illustrated by the curve in the lower part of this picture. And thus, if we use the amplitude analysis of the signal from each photomultiplier, then we could identify the that just pixel which irradiated the corresponding photomultiplier tube. The efficiency of such four-switch system are presented here. It is the efficiency in different energy ranges, and this curve presents the total efficiency for all interactions of gamma quanta in both scintillators. And other curves present the different kinds of gamma quanta detection. This and this curve corresponds the gamma quanta detected in the field of view of the instrument, it means the gamma quanta fallen on the instrument from above, and this curve presents the efficiency for gamma quanta fallen in opposite direction just from spacecraft. That means it is the efficiency of background gamma quanta detection. And if we will realize the total anti-coincidence system, which in which all events in protection and cesium iodide protection will be forbidden, then the efficiency will be presented by curve number 3, and we could see that efficiency will not very high in the energy, just higher than a half of a MeV, because of the large number of Compton events, which will irradiate both insulators as sodium iodide pixels, as cesium iodide crystal. Thus, maybe the alternative variant could be realized, in which the more soft criterion could be used without forbidden of all events in cesium iodide crystal, but only those for which the amplitude of the signal in cesium iodide crystal will be less than in sodium iodide. And here we could see the position sensitive detector model as it's seen it is the top view. Here we could see the crystal pixel crystals and a few photomultipliers, which are viewed as pixels as protection insulator. And it is the typical energy spectrum of measured for this model, for this laboratory model, from americium isotope. It is about 60 keV peak. And this curve present the dependencies of light output detected by photomultiplier in dependence of pixel position, and also the dependence of energy resolution, also in the on pixel position. Thus, we could see that if we have a pixel placed far from the center of photomultiplier, of course, its number of light photons will be less, and thus the relative value of output signal will be also less, and also the energy resolution will be worse for such crystals. And what is we think what is should be noted, that such a configuration could be used for polarization measurements, even in the case of a plane position of position sensitive detector pixels. There we don't use the typical Compton telescope configuration, which means two layers of pixelized detectors. Here we have only one layer of pixelized detector, but due to Compton scattering, in the case of pixel size, which could be optimized for this task, I think that for sodium iodide insulator, it may be about a half of a centimeter diameter. It is quite enough for effective Compton scattering, and this picture illustrates how we could measure the polarization. If we have a plane polarization, as it is well known, the intensity of scattered quantum distribution is given by this formula, and the polarization plane is normal to the direction of gamma ray beam protect gamma ray beam, and thus if we realize the pair coincidence of different pairs of scintillators, we then could identify events corresponds the one plane of detector in the case of polarization, if the detector gamma ray flux have polarization, will have polarization. And also configuration of position sensitive detector consists from two different kinds of scintillators, allow us to realize a good protection from local gamma quanta, and such configuration based on the well-known Fossich technique, which illustrated by such a two-dimensional diagram on which we could see the different events plotted in such a way that on x-axis the intensity of fast component, that means the sodium iodide scintillator event, and on the y-axis the slow component, which means the cesium iodide scintillator signals are plotted. And this diagram shows two kinds of events. This part corresponds to the events in the upper layer of pixelated scintillator, and this part corresponds to the cesium iodide scintillator events, and we could effectively separate them by the use of some criterion which could be introduced in electronic circuits. And also the such combination of detectors allows us to separate different types of detected particles. And here it is the result of calculations which show the spectra of energy deposits in both scintillators from gamma quanta here and electrons. Red, the energy deposits in sodium iodide crystals, and green, the energy deposits in cesium iodide crystal, and the corresponding curves for electrons. We could see that gamma quanta and electrons characterize the quite different dependencies, and it gives us an opportunity to separate such events by analysis of amplitudes in both scintillators. And the next way of improving the properties of position sensitive detector is to use new kind of scintillator such as pixel. Instead of sodium iodide scintillator, now we examine the new type of scintillator, so-called lanthanum bromide scintillators. And we use now such crystals obtained in Russian Institute of Solid State Physics. And here we could see the typical energy spectrum from gafnium isotope with several lines obtained with this new scintillator. And also we examine now the cerium bromide scintillator for possible crystal, for possible pixel material. And here we could see the energy resolution of both size scintillators obtained at various photomultiplier tube voltage in energy range from about 30 keV up to about 2 MeV. And we could see that such scintillators give quite enough energy resolution, about 3-4% at the line corresponds near the 1 MeV. Also, we test such scintillators on its stability after the irradiation by neutron fluxes. It was the joint work with Garching Max Planck Institute, led by Dr. Yudin. And results of this work we could see here, to the typical spectrum of bromide lantan scintillators after the irradiation by neutrons. And we could see how the light output is changing after such irradiation. And this picture gives us information about the energy resolution, which is quite stable after the activation. Thus, we could see that such crystals are rather good for their use in a space experiment. Yes. Neutron flux, as I understand, about several MeV, yes? From five neutrons, from reactor. Maybe it is given here, no?
No, it will need to calculate for this activation time.
Yes. And also, we realize the detailed digital modeling of this gamma ray telescope. First of all, with the purpose of obtaining the images with the use of combination of coding mask and position sensitive detector. It is the illustration of one such combination for one detector unit and one coding mask segment. And here we could see the example of such modeling. The different color illustrates the intensity in each pixel for the gamma quanta falling normally to the mask plate. And for this instrument, we optimize the coding mask pattern, and we use so-called spiral pattern with varying distance between holes in the coding mask panel. And here we could see the image reconstruction or one point source. It is the only mathematical image without any real instrument background, but we could see here so-called background of false images, which depends on, mainly on coding mask pattern. And we see here that such background is quite uniform, and thus this a pattern is quite appropriate for our purposes, as we think. And it is the real model, or really a laboratory model of such element made from tantalum. And it is the result of gamma absorption in such tantalum elements. And we could see that it is efficiency of absorption is quite enough for the range about from several Dalton keV up to about half of a MeV. And of course, near 1 MeV, it becomes quite transparent for gamma quanta. Also, we estimate by calculations the error box of GRB, which could be detected with this instrument. In this plot, we could see the estimation of such error box for the case if we use the position-sensitive detector as whole, without positioning of each event, but we use detector as gamma camera, as it is idea like a Betsy instrument when we use detector and estimate by different counts from each detectors. And in such mode, we could see that it is the size, typical size of error box, in dependence on direction of the detected GRB, independence of the angle from the instrument axis. And
it is a very bright GRB.
Yes, it is a bright GRB, of course. And we could see that for a bright GRB, the error box on the edge of the instrument field of view is rather higher. And for the central event, it will be about 1 degree or even less. We have such plots for any intensity, not only for very high, but also, of course, the lower intensity, the lower affluence, the larger error box will be. And also we have made a reconstruction of different real sky sources, well known from different gamma ray surveys. For the case of a real gamma ray telescope orientation on the spacecraft, for typical, we use the variant of Lomonosov satellite as a, how to say, as a pathfinder of this experiment. And here we also introduce the expected background, which we know from our previous, many of our previous gamma ray experiments on board spacecraft. And it is a typical image reconstruction of several sources for one orbit, for one orbital motion. And it is a sky map obtained from this survey catalog. We could see here the number of sources near the galactic center. It is the Crab region and Cygnus region. And here it is in more detail. Sky map reconstruction. And it is corresponding map obtained from integral IBIS catalog. And in conclusion, the several words about the use of optics. As I already said, we now prepare experiment on board Mikhail Lomonosov, and it will be our first experience in the use of wide field optic cameras in space experiment. And we think that in the case of the successful realization of this experiment, we will also use such optical cameras in combination with wide field gamma ray telescope. It is the typical laboratory model of wide field camera, and different kinds of camera which could be used with objectives. And it is the camera which just will be used in Lomonosov. It is of this type, wide field camera. And it is a quantum output for this camera in different wavelength. And it is also the quantum output in different bands. And now we could see it is the real instrument. It is the camera and electronics and a box. Of course, it is with open cover. And just such instruments will be used in Lomonosov. There will be two cameras, also co-aligned with corresponding gamma ray detectors, with the main purpose to detect the GLB prompt emission. And then they think that in such a way we will realize the observation in wide field gamma ray telescope also. In this case, for each gamma ray detector will be used corresponding the wide field camera. That means the fixed cameras will be used in this experiment. And in conclusion, this image, it is a real sky image obtained by ground observation with this wide field camera, with Lomonosov wide field camera, for 0.2 second exposition, with a mount which modeling the real satellite scanning. This mount rotated with period about hour and a half, and for this real situation, as it will be on board satellite, this sky map was obtained. This is all the final picture.